Hey everyone, this is Morgan Yates. Recently for the month of September, I decided to take on the challenge of eating plant-based for the entire month, and this is what happened. So before we hop into all the details of what the past month has entailed, thank you so much to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. If you're not already familiar with Skillshare, they are an online learning community of creatives where millions of people come together to learn new skills and develop their passions. They have thousands of classes available on topics like videography and photography to marketing and freelancing. Most class segments are under an hour long, so they can fit into your schedule whenever you have time to take them. Before I began the journey to be plant-based for this month, I watched their course called Vegan Eating, Build Your Plant-Based Meal Plan for Veganism, Health, and Workouts, I believe is what it was called. And it was super informative to me, specifically pertaining to like the protein question, I guess, and talking through good plant-based protein sources. You can join Skillshare for less than $10 a month with an annual subscription, and members get unlimited access to all of their courses. And the first 1,000 people to join at my link in the description box will get a free trial of their premium membership. So check that out if you're interested. And thank you again to them for sponsoring this video. Let's go ahead and hop into my month of veganism. First up, for why I wanted to do this. First, and this might seem random, the correlation here, but my skin's been out of control. And in the past, when I've cut out dairy or like way cut down on it for brief periods, I see a huge difference in my skin. So I wanted to see if my acne that's been going on lately has really been caused by like masks, or if it's just been my diet. I feel like I've been eating more dairy. I just want to cut it out, see what happens. Secondly, I just felt like I had been eating a lot of the same meals all the time. Obviously, a vegan diet is much better for the environment. My goal in setting out to do this was to kind of remind myself and to show people that it's not that hard to eat plant-based for people who want to. So let's just hop into our 30 days.
Day one. Excuse the zit cream. This is exactly why we're doing this.
Morning, I'm making breakfast. I just got out my pan. If you follow me on anything, you may know I make this bomb avocado toast every single day of life that includes an egg on top. But now that's not an option.
So this is gonna be such a sad breakfast. The egg on the avocado toast is gonna be the hardest thing, I think, of this entire month.
This is our still delicious looking but kind of sad breakfast. I feel like I'm gonna be hungry in probably like an hour, I don't know. Working today. Wanted sweet green, as I always do. Every single day I crave this. I could literally eat it every single day. We've gone for a vegan option today. We have some spicy broccoli, sweet potatoes, quinoa, kale, tomatoes, avocado, and then I got the pesto vinaigrette and the sweet green hot sauce. Basically, it's like I've taken the core of the chicken pesto parm salad and like veganized it. Good lunchtime option while I edit.
Dinner, because I still need to get groceries. Shelby and I have decided to get veggie grill. Not the healthiest. This is a little buffalo sandwich. I got it lettuce style, and I have some sweet potato fries. And for some dessert, I got vegan chocolate and peanut butter frozen yogurt. So yummy. So I'm making my grocery list, coming up with some meal ideas. And I do have a few things in here that are vegan. However, stuff like this that I thought was vegan, it contains egg and milk ingredients, so I can't even eat stuff like this.
Right off the bat, I had quite a little slip up. I was at Target, you know, as I am, roaming the aisles, you know, I see the Starbucks. It's like a magnet. Next thing I knew, I was there, I'd ordered the pumpkin cream cold brew because hello fall, and I'm just like sipping it. And when I got home, I realized that that was not vegan.
Guys, this is not vegan. What was I thinking? You're telling me I gotta forego a month's worth of fall drinks? I've messed up on my vegan thing. It's only day three. Whatever, it's one small thing. It's not gonna set us back, but I can't believe it.
For tonight's vegan dinner, I'm attempting a little cauliflower taco recipe. I got this from my friend Caitlin B. She did a vegan what I eat in a day video. I'll have it linked. Basically, we're just gonna cook up these cauliflower florets in taco seasoning and then top it with this Trader Joe's cabbage mix. And then it's just kind of free for all with your toppings. Probably cut up some jalapeno, a little avo, a little lime juice. All right, we're gonna give it the taste test.
I've decided I'm gonna make some vegan nachos because at Trader Joe's I discovered this cashew fiesta dip. It tastes like some bomb nacho cheese, I think heated up on top of some little vegan nachos. It's gonna be a great time. So yeah, we're gonna have black beans. I'm making some quinoa that's gonna be kind of like a taco meat. It's gonna be seasoned really deliciously. Just gonna saute some onion, red pepper, tomato action really quick.
Turned out to be a ton, but I'm so excited. The quinoa tastes taco-y. We have black beans under there. What I knew from the beginning was gonna be my biggest challenge was coming up with alternative things to eat for breakfast. That might not seem like a big thing, you know, having to swap that out, but I've eaten that every day for breakfast for like practically a year, it feels like. I dabbled with some other options, you know, cereal, oat milk, and fruit. I give that like 4 out of 10. Oatmeal with like blueberries and some chia seeds, because oats and chia seeds are a good source of protein according to my Skillshare course. However, oatmeal, bad. 3 out of 10. One day I did make a breakfast burrito though.
We got our potatoes cooking. We got some peppers, tomatoes, onions, mushrooms, jalapeno cooking. At the end, I'm gonna add in some soy chorizo from Trader Joe's, mix it all together, wrap it in a tortilla. This is gonna be my beach day lunch. So I'm on the beach, as I am every Saturday. And typically when we go home at night, we post-made dinner, usually from this delicious chicken place in LA. It's called Main Chick Hot Chick. We love it. I can't have that now, and so I planned in advance to set myself up for success to Postmate Sweet Green or this taco place that has a lot of delicious vegan taco options. But as I sit here more and more, and I'm more and more Truly's, I just want Main Chick, but I can't do it. But that's all I'm thinking about, and it's still hours away, so we're gonna see how I hold up. Vegan taco dinner. All right, for dinner, I'm feeling lazy and I'm not starving, so straight from the freezer, I have this Kung Pao tempura cauliflower from Trader Joe's that I've never tried. I actually ended up putting over some jasmine rice I had left over. Some of these pieces of cauliflower are huge, but the flavor is there. This is my week one skin update. These red marks are just kind of like scars for me, like, you know, picking at stuff, popping stuff. Actually, most all of that is. I really only feel like a couple of places actually under my skin. But I can tell a huge difference. Like, everything's kind of just like healing up. I'm not getting like a bunch of active new breakouts like around here as much, even though this is like where your mask goes. That could also have been a big association here, but I'm wearing my mask as much as I have been. And I know that dairy, according to my esthetician, also really affects your acne like around here. I don't know. We'll see how it fares in the next few weeks. I've always been kind of a snack luncher as it is, so one thing I've just been having for lunch is a big ol' smoothie with some protein powder. I actually think this one tastes good. So a favorite smoothie combo of mine has been like banana, fresh mint, chocolate, oat milk, and then this flavor doesn't really go together, but I don't know why in any smoothie, especially like a strawberry fruity smoothie, I always finish it off these days with a spoonful of sunflower seed butter. I think this tastes so good. Just for, again, like some added protein, we have 8 grams in this little 2 tablespoon serving. Probably have like a tablespoon and a half. I don't really measure anything. So I don't know how I'm doing on my values of, you know, carbs, fats, protein, things like that. I just intuitively eat. It's worked out for me so far. I just like a go-to snack because I usually, you know, snack some as well. This red pepper hummus from Trader Joe's. It's just like some pretzel crisps. Pretzel thins, delicious. In a moment of forgetfulness, I also put spinach. Yummy yum. She is hefty, as you can see.
I guess I'll walk through like typical meals for lunch and dinner as well. So for my lunches, not tons changed for me. I'll be snacking on like hummus and pretzels or carrots or fruit. A lot of times I actually just eat leftovers from like dinner the night before because I usually make a little extra on purpose, because in the middle of my workday, I don't have the energy or the time or the passion to like cook a real lunch. Although a couple of times in the spirit of like trying some new stuff, I actually found something I really like that was this like kale, sweet potato, garlicky, like little hash situation. Tasted bomb. However, I couldn't help but think that like a piece of bacon cooked in there, crumbled up, would have added a lot more flavor too.
For dinner, we've got some chickpeas, some spicy roasted sweet potatoes, asparagus, quinoa, woo, and then some red pepper hummus for some flavor.
My sad vegan dessert.
Actually, for lunch, we're having leftovers from last night's dinner. Forgot I made extra.
For dinners, this is where it was a little tricky. What I consider to be a very healthy, yummy dinner would be like making some salmon and some veggies. A go-to for me was like a little veggie grain bowl. I had to make several vegan taco varieties. I feel like that's a really easy thing to make vegan.
All right, for dinner, I'm feeling tacos. A longtime favorite of mine is this soy chorizo from Trader Joe's. It's processed fake meat. I don't know what this means, so I feel like that's never good. But I digress. This is what's for dinner. It is delicious. I cook up like my taco base with this, some red pepper, onion, tomatoes. I have some mushrooms I might throw in as well. We're gonna top these tacos with some lettuce, fresh sliced up jalapeno, avocado. Here she goes.
Also, like 10 days into this month, I decided that I was actually gonna be moving houses. So my life got extremely crazy as I was like packing and trying to get ahead on videos and things like that. Convenient meals and convenient dinners especially actually became very important. So I feel like I was reaching for a lot of like frozen things for dinners, like things I could just put in the oven and like go do other tasks and then just like eat it. When it comes to like frozen vegan things, I mean, there were good options. I didn't get tired of them for the month, but I feel like it's a lot easier to eat like non-vegan quick frozen meals.
All right, for dinner tonight, well, first we have some wine. Thank God that's vegan. I've been loving these chicken pot sticker things that they have in the frozen section. I picked up this Thai veggie one. So I'm gonna have some of this with some broccoli and mushrooms and then some rice. That's gonna be a little quick vegan dinner.
Here she is, gonna do a taste test.
This is bomb. Mmm, I like. So I've been missing my desserts so much. And one of you guys let me know on a different video about something that is not healthy at all, but that is accidentally vegan. They're a little stale, actually. I don't know about those.
All right, week 2 skin update. Looking better. On this side, we have a lot of red scars from former things, but they're like not active at the moment. Like this side is glowing. She looks good. Could we bring this energy around? Also, my like neck, I was having some like breakouts around like the bottom part of my neck. As you can tell, it's all clearing up under here. This is great. This is what I wanted. I credit that to the no dairy. My roommates are trying to torture me. This is everything I miss. The best place called Main Chick in LA. It's this like bomb hot chicken.
I literally could never go vegan because of
Main Chick. Yeah, it's the best chicken. Like this is the hardest thing. And I just had vegan leftovers from last night. It was actually really good, but just in comparison, now I really want that. Today we're making a little breakfast potato moment. We got some red pepper, onion, potatoes. I picked up this tomato ketchup with black summer truffle from Trader Joe's a while ago and still haven't tried it.
It smells amazing.
You smell it.
Oh my God! What is that?
It's truffle! Yum. This is like top 5 things I've ever bought from there, I think.
Week 3 skin update. Whoa.
Like, it makes a huge difference in your skin. I would say more than any skincare product. Like, every single thing on my face is just a mark left from me picking at previous things. My skin is actually like clear of any kind of like anything in my pores.
I've been on a 2-week stretch of no post-mating, and Adrian is to blame. She just tempted me because she was getting sweet green. So anyways, that's my dinner. It's no secret, I love to post-mate some food every now and then. So being in LA, very lucky here that we do have a lot of vegan options. So zooming back out to like the progression of this month, the first couple of weeks, I felt like this was just gonna be a breeze. But as I got into the craziness of like this house and just really needing convenience, what I noticed kind of, I guess, the second half of this month, as I started to eat a lot more frozen, especially the past week, my gosh. My skin right now, you can't see under this makeup, is terrible again. It gotten so good at like week 3 and then, you know, we right back. And I feel like it's because I was eating just like processed frozen stuff that still was vegan, but like, is it good for you? So the first like half of this month, I was feeling so good because I was eating really clean. Past couple weeks just goes to show like people can be vegan and like if they wanted eat McDonald's french fries every day. You know what I mean? Like vegan does not equal healthy, but like what I really set out to do that I didn't fully accomplish was to eat like mostly whole foods, like really healthy. That is when you feel the best, and I certainly did. However, I will say, you know, obviously we can't all be perfectly healthy 24/7. I guess the takeaway here is that if you do want to be vegan, no matter how busy you are, there are enough frozen things on the market that are still vegan so that you can make that work regardless of like how much time you have. It's not like you don't have options. But as the month went on, there were a few days that I was just so over it. I wanted, like, I would see somebody make a cheese board on Instagram and I was like, ugh.
It is the first day I have craved just like meat or like chicken, I guess. I really thought it was getting to the point where I was like, this isn't even a challenge, this is like very easy. But today I'm craving like some Chick-fil-A or just like some fried chicken. This is the first day I really do like miss non-vegan food.
Tonight I thought we'd make a little cauliflower gnocchi full of lots of green veggies and with this vegan kale, cashew, and basil pesto from Trader Joe's. I bought this stuff for forever, it's so good.
I did have another little slip up.
It's come to my realization that me last night, after bottomless mimosas during the day, got cheesy pasta for dinner last night.
I had this delicious like carbonara-y type pasta that was so good. Do I regret it?
Not really, but did I slip up? Yeah, I for sure did. And sincerely, I swear, I just like didn't have the thought. This video is called I Tried Going Vegan for a Reason. So we did make it to the end, and for some reflections, the first time I went to Trader Joe's picking up all my groceries for a couple weeks, I was shocked with like the cheapest grocery bill I have ever had. I was started thinking and I was like, that makes so much sense because your meats, your like fish, your dairy, all those things are, I feel like, so much more expensive. So that's a pro to eating more plant-based. Secondly, my skin was so much better. Maybe it got worse again because I had that pasta, you know, maybe that's what I get here. Cut out dairy, your skin's gonna be popping. I've seen that time and time again in my life, and I don't know why that never fully motivates me to stay away. As I look back over my month too, if I were doing this beyond a month and like more long-term, I feel like maybe I would actually kind of like map out my nutrients and calories and whatnot, just like get an idea of how much protein I'm getting so that I can adjust accordingly. But for a month, I don't know, I was just, you know, focused on just not slipping up. I'm gonna go back to eating now that my month of this is over. For the most part, when I'm just at home cooking, I try to make sure that what I'm eating is like nutritious, like for lack of a better word. So I'm going back to eating like as many whole foods as possible, but just with like a little sprinkle of like some dairy or meat mixed in. You know, you can substitute, of course, like pretty much whatever you want into a vegan diet, but some things just, in my opinion, aren't the same. However, still, as I've said, in my opinion, it's not that hard to be vegan. It just takes more thought here and there, but I feel like it is something you get used to. The things you miss at first, I feel like, fade with time. Throughout this, I did find some new vegan products, some new vegan meal ideas, those cauliflower tacos. So there are things that are lasting beyond just this 30 days. That is it. That's what my past month has been like. Let me know if this is something that you guys would ever try or if you have tried it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.